afternoon, friends. I will give you a brief update on the situation. We have been meeting regularly, as you know, and we have been updating you about the various things that we have been doing. On the 28th of March, we had updated you about the various measures that we were taking and the overall situation. And you're also aware that keeping in view the situation, we had decided to do it through an online mode, and you had all responded very proactively. So I'm very happy that today all of you are maintaining social distancing and protecting yourselves. We will start with the brief situation as it exists today. As you are aware that our last meeting was on the 28th of March when we had given you a detailed update. As we speak today, like in the rest of the country, the number of cases in J&K is also showing an increase. The number of cases, which was 27 on March 28th, has now risen to 62. This includes 58 active cases, of which 48 are in Kashmir and 10 are in Jammu division. There are a total of 17,041 cases which are under active surveillance so far. When we say this, I must also clarify that this is a dynamic process, and while contact tracing is bringing more people into surveillance, there are also people who are completing their surveillance period and are being released for home quarantine, and newer cases are being added. So it's an ongoing process. We are conscious of the fact that there has been concern among the people at large about the cases being tested positive. However, we would like to emphasize that we have a robust contact tracing process in place, and many of the cases that we are seeing positive today could only be traced as a result of a vigorous and scientific contact tracing exercise undertaken by the administration. As a result, we were able to trace many cases, including some which were asymptomatic. This is extremely important because if not traced, these cases could have continued in the general population and could even have infected more people. We will continue to actively pursue this strategy. We have identified nearly 2,000 contacts which we believe can be traced to the positive cases. We have issued instructions that no known contact be left untraced. I had mentioned last time, and I reiterate, that this contact tracing is bound to lead to some inconvenience. Hotspots would need to be isolated. Movements would need to be strictly restricted. I appeal for your cooperation in all this. Believe me, it is worth the time, it is worth the effort, and it is worth the inconvenience. Every single case detected and traced means so many more have been prevented from being infected. We in Jammu and Kashmir have also been testing cases aggressively. We were among the first to start testing locally through our 4 testing centers, all in the government sector, in our hospitals in Jammu as well as Kashmir. Our testing rate at 77.5 per million is one of the highest in India and probably next only to Kerala. We will aggressively continue our testing strategy as well. In fact, we will further increase it. To begin with, we plan to test every single one of the 2,000 contacts that we have identified. So we will follow this twofold strategy. We will trace out each one of the 2,000 contacts that we have identified, and having traced them out, we will test every single one of them. Our strategy so far has borne results, and we are confident that continuation of this strategy will lead to better results. We have in place well-defined protocols for quarantine, isolation, restrictions for movement. in defining these protocols, we have sometimes gone beyond what is being followed in some other states. However, wherever this is being done, this has been carefully planned. Wherever we have been deliberately stricter, we firmly believe that it is better to be strict and firm now than dealing with a large number of infections at a later stage. We had already briefed you last time about the 11 exclusive hospitals that we have kept aside, about the administrative quarantine facility of 35,000 beds and of 2,400 earmarked treatment beds. Today, I only want to reiterate that in addition to upgrading, ramping up facilities, we will also ramp up manpower. The health department has already started doing so. It has started re-engagement of retired professionals, consultants, and it will continue to use every possible mechanism to ensure that there is absolutely no shortage of manpower. Similarly, it is going ahead with procuring all essential materials, including masks, PPEs, ventilators, etc. While we are doing all this on the health front, we are also aware that there are a large number of citizens and residents who need support and assistance of various kinds. These include patients, students, migrant labor, and other citizens. Adequate arrangements have been made for each and every group of people. The Resident Commission in Delhi has established a 24/7 helpline to assist students, patients, or any other residents of Jammu and Kashmir who are currently outside Jammu and Kashmir and facing difficulties due to the lockdown. In the past 4 days alone, nearly 3,000 calls have been received on these numbers and people have been assisted. The Labour Department has set up helplines for labour and migrants, both interstate migrant labourers in J&K and migrant labor of J&K currently in different parts of the country. On this helpline too, over 300 calls have been received so far. An amount of rupees 1000 per registered construction worker was approved by the government on the 25th of March 2020. The process of transferring this money to the accounts of eligible labor through DBT mode has already started. Nearly 12 crores have been disbursed till date and another 9 crores will be disbursed shortly. In addition, we have issued an advisory to all employers in public sector, private sector, shops, establishments, industrial establishments, factories, projects, contractors throughout Jammu and Kashmir, asking them not to terminate their employees, particularly casual or contractual workers, or to reduce their wages in view of their ongoing situation. We had also told you that advance ration for 2 months for April and May would be issued to all eligible people. This process has also begun and nearly 1.3 lakh quintal of food grains have been distributed so far. This process will continue. In addition, to help the destitute, slum dwellers, migrant laborers, ration packet containing essential edibles are being prepared and supplied through urban local bodies, deputy commissioners, and other parts of the administrative machinery. Nearly 30,000 people are being assisted in this manner. We had heard some concern about the supply chain of essential commodities. I wish to inform you, reassure you, that the position of supplies is absolutely normal. In order to maintain the supply line of essential commodities, medicines, baby foods, all other items, special arrangements have been made across the Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir and especially at Lakhanpur. Since the beginning of the lockdown and up to the 8 a.m. of today, nearly 3,400 trucks carrying essential goods, including fruit, vegetable, around 1,100 trucks, ration food grains, around 1,000 trucks, milk, 100 trucks, eggs, 130 trucks, medicines, 100 trucks, LPG, 300 trucks, POL, 100 trucks have entered Jammu and Kashmir from Lakhanpur. In addition, cattle feed and fodder 230 trucks, fertilizers 19 trucks, and trucks carrying poultry and sheep have also been allowed. On an average, we are seeing around 800 trucks of essential supplies entering Jammu and Kashmir through Lakhanpur. We would like to assure you that we are maintaining a close and continuous watch on every aspect of the situation, whether it is the medical front, whether it is tracing, tracking, testing of cases, whether it is ramping up supplies, whether it is providing for quarantine and isolation facilities, whether it is taking care of any people who may be needing help in times of the situation, whether it is assisting students, whether it is assisting migrant labor. We are looking at every aspect. We are distributing rations to the destitute and the slum dwellers. We are maintaining supply lines of essential commodities. We are providing essential rations, advanced rations for midday meals. So I assure you that all these things are being looked into. All I ask you is for your cooperation. And your cooperation, as I said, is in following advisories, in self-declaring foreign travel, in maintaining personal hygiene, and in cooperating with the administration whenever contact tracing is being carried out. I reiterate, there will be some inconvenience, there will be some difficulty, but we are all in this together. We have to fight together, we have to win together, and I am sure that we will. Thank you very much.